All right, hi there. So we've got a Mr. Coffee pot that is not brewing. The brew lights are coming on, but nothing's happening. So I'm going to take it apart and see if we can fix this. All right, so the first thing you want to do is you want to take the bottom off. There are several screws located in the bottom. You can see one right here. So we're going to take the bottom off, and then we're going to take a look at inside and see what's going on. This model has 7 screws, so I've got the screws taken out. So we're just going to take the bottom off, and that reveals this is the heating element here, and then these are the tubes that lead from the water reservoir. The water comes through here, in through the heating element, and then back up, and that feeds the supply to the coffee ground. To remove this heating element, it's pretty straightforward. There are screws, 2 screws that hold this bracket in place, and that's what secures the heating element to this warming plate on the bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and just remove these 2 screws and remove this heating element. So as you can see, I've got the heating element removed, and next I am going to go ahead and remove these clips. There is clips down below and above, so I do want to remove both of these clips, and that will remove these tubes. This is a tube that supplies water. This is the from the water reservoir, and it comes down through this tube, and there is a ball valve right here, and my hunch is that this ball valve might not be working properly, and that's why we're not getting water supplied to the heating element. So I'm going to take this out and go ahead and clean that, and then we'll reinstall it and see if that fixes the issue. Okay, so now you've got your coffee pot open. You notice right here, this is a supply tube for the water. There is a small, if you can see that there, red ball that controls the flow of the water. Looks like there is some buildup in there, so I'm going to go ahead and take this off. There's a clamp right up in here. And I'm going to take that clamp out, take the hose off, and clean that out real good, and we'll reinstall that. So here's a better look at that tube that supplies water. You can see right where my thumb is, there's a little red ball in there, and there is some scale and buildup in there, so I'm going to go ahead and take some soapy water brush and clean that out, because it looks like that might be sticking and blocking the water flow. Okay, so we're back, and I've got that really cleaned. I had a brush and just put a little bit of soapy water in there and cleaned that out real good. If the way to tell that this, that's actually a valve, is working correctly is if you blow air in one end, you'll get a nice flow of air. And if you blow air in the other end, if you reverse it and blow air that way, you will not get any air going through that, and then you'll know that that valve is working properly. Shake it, and you can hear that that ball is now loose and ready to reinstall that. All right, so I've got the supply tubes, the rubber tubes, connected back to the heating element. And by the way, while you have this heating element out, you do want to run some wire through here to see if you can remove any hard water deposits, calcium deposits. This was pretty good. I think the issue was this valve up in here. So it's pretty pretty straightforward. You just reassemble it the way you disconnected it. We'll put these clamps on in just a minute. I wanted to attach the heating element to the warming plate. Once I do that, I'll put the clips back and button it back up and hopefully make a cup of coffee. Okay, and as you can see, we are brewing coffee. because I'm not ready for a cup of coffee. So, yeah, if you have trouble with the Mr. Coffee, or actually any coffee maker for that matter, go ahead, pull it apart. Check out that the supply tube that's coming from the chamber down to the heating element, and go ahead and clean out that tube and make sure that that valve is unclogged. So there you have it.